Match game 74, production number 0158. Air date to be announced, BTR 215-74. Take one. Get ready to match the stars. Steve Allen. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Fannie Flagg. Richard Dawson. And Kay Ballard. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene River.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you for joining us here in person and all of you on in television land. How are all of you celebrated and beautiful people?
What compared to what?
May compared. I say something?
You may say something.
I would like to tell America that Gene Rayburn showed me his needlepoint in his dressing room.
Oh.
That's true, he did.
And it's really sharp.
And he does both.
Well, I thank you. I fly a lot, and you can read so much, and then you got to do
a
little needlepoint, right?
And that's why he does needlepoint.
No, I don't do needlepoint because I fly. Listen, I'm going to leave you people and say hello to these people. Hello, Sue DiBenedetto, current champion, and hello, Valerie Wood. How are you? Sue has won $5,600, and she's very happy about that. She's won one game, went all the way. And Valerie Wood, we're meeting for the first time. Would you tell us a little bit about yourself?
I live in Huntington Beach with my husband, Richard, and I have two lovely daughters, Kim and Pam. And we like boating and golfing.
You like?
Boating.
Boating and golfing.
Mm-hmm.
How do you get a golf course on a boat there?
It isn't easy.
It isn't easy.
I like boating, but only if there's a sailor that goes with it.
Well, Valerie, we're very delighted to meet you and have you with us. We'll start this game. Good luck to both ladies right after we start this message. Okay, here we go with a brand new game. A push a button, reveal two questions. Ask our challenger, Valerie, to make a selection.
B, please.
We ask you to do that because some contestants find some questions harder than others, although we make an effort to make them all of equal difficulty. Here we go. The farmer said to the ranch hand, "How many times do I have to tell you, don't blank the cows while they're being milked?" Aren't you glad you came, Steve?
Particularly, Steve.
How many times do I have to tell you, don't blank the cows while they're being milked? Said the farmer to the ranch hand. All right. Okay. Are you a farm boy, Charles?
I am.
You're a farm girl, that's right.
I don't do needlepoint, I know that.
Because he hasn't tried.
Okay, they're all set over there. So, Valerie, we get your response now to this. The farmer said to the ranch hand, "How many times do I have to tell you, don't blank the cows while they're being milked?"
Kicked.
Don't what?
Kicked.
Don't kick?
Kick.
Oh. Don't kick the cows while they're being milked? That's what she says. Okay. She says, don't kick the cows while they're being milked. I don't understand that. Steve, do you understand that?
No, and I'm making no attempt to, frankly. I just ignore it, leap right over it, and I suggest don't frighten the cows
don't
while they're
the
being
cows.
Milked.
Yeah, that's right, because they could
I'll
wag
right
their
out.
Tails at you. Brett, what did you say?
I'm a farm girl.
Yes.
And you could give a cow a little kick. He wouldn't give you any milk, or she wouldn't give you any milk. I said, don't let the goose in.
Don't, it says here, don't let the goose in while the cows are being milked. Right. Give her a good long buzz on that, would you please? A long buzz. Charles, what do you say? Kick is the answer Valerie's looking for.
Getting back to the game, I said feed. I'm sorry,
don't
Valerie.
Feed the cows
don't
while
feed.
They're getting
oh, that's
up.
As dumb as don't let the goose in.
All right. Hello there.
Hello there.
You're a southern farm girl, aren't you?
Yes. The most famous cow in the world is Lily Flagg.
Really?
Yes, and it's Lily Flagg, Alabama. It was named after a cow. I said...
It looks like one, too.
What'd you say?
I said, not brand. Oh, brand the
do
cow.
Do not brand the cow while it's being milked.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
good.
Fanny, yeah. that's a dumb answer.
Dumb answer? How about, have you got a dumb answer too, Richard?
That's a good answer. You get hot milk that way, wouldn't you?
Okay.
So I said, don't bother the old moo cow. Oh.
Don't bother the cow. Oh. What did you say, oh, dear girl?
I said, don't scare, which don't. Is the same as frighten. Oh. And nobody has said it, and I don't care.
Okay. The don't kick didn't work for you. Let's see how this works for Sue. Oh, everybody plays. At the hospital, Steve passed out when the nurse showed him his blank. That's what it says right there. Would you like to...
At the hospital?
At the hospital, Steve passed out when the nurse showed him his blank. Now, you've all been in hospitals, haven't you?
I have. You want me to tell you about my operation?
Not with Steve. Kay, you can think of something.
Oh, yes, yes.
Let's see what you got. All right. Yeah. Charles is finishing up.
Well, I don't understand.
And we'll get a response from Sue. At the hospital, Steve passed out when the nurse showed him his...
tonsils.
Tonsils. Really? Is that all you can think of? Tonsils, huh? That's all she could think of, Steve. What did you think of?
I know I got a big mouth, but nobody can show me my tonsils. I think I would pass out under some circumstances, perhaps if the nurse showed me my x-rays.
X-rays.
But what do I know?
Your x-rays are upside down. How can you read your x-rays upside down?
That's why I passed out.
All right, Brett.
I feel now is as good a time as any to tell you the bad news, Steve. Medical report.
Medical report. Tonsils are the answer.
Oh, you're going to get it one of these days.
I think you just got it. Charles?
I said baby.
Baby. That's the answer. See, if the audience were playing, that's the answer.
That's the best applause I've had in 9 years.
That's right. They think you're very smart. What about you?
Baby.
Baby.
I ain't got a big applause.
This audience is a baby freak audience. They like babies. How about you?
They eat their old yogurt. Oh, I've seen Steve's babies, and you wouldn't pass out. They're handsome.
Yeah, right.
Debonair.
Sure.
They're wealthy. Anyway, I said he passed out when he saw his appendix.
Appendix. That could be a frightening sight.
Well, if you people are going to owe appendixes.
Tonsils is what she's looking for.
How many appendixes do you owe?
I don't owe any.
Oh, all right. Well, let them owe for you then.
I was saying that I went to a very cheap school.
Yes.
And the only thing I could come up with was like needle, a shot. You know what I mean?
Oh, that needle. When he showed him the needle, he gave him the shot. Okay. So the score at the end of round one is 0-0. And we'll go to round two right after we do a little business with you. And this is it.
Tune in, turn on, and blank out.
All right, we're set to carry on now with round two. Valerie, which one do you want, A or B?
B again.
B. She didn't match anyone in the first round, so that means everybody plays in the second round. The big bad wolf said, I just came from a house where this old lady had the biggest blank I ever saw. I read it wrong. Hold everything. I read it wrong.
You could have fooled us.
No, you read it brilliantly.
There was an S on the blank.
Say it again.
I said biggest blank, and this old lady had the biggest blanks I ever saw. I said blank at first.
The big bad wolf said that?
Yes. Big bad wolf said, I just came from a house where this old lady had the biggest blanks I ever saw. Hello, darling.
How are you?
Would you write something on the card?
Yes.
And join the fun? Oh, you did. You did it already. Good for you.
This one came to me late.
Just like that. You're familiar with the big bad wolf, are you? All right. Okay.
Come on, Childs. Finish. Stop the music. Valerie, the big bad wolf said I just came from a house where this old lady had the biggest blanks I ever saw.
Boobs.
Mother Nature.
Well, it's not nice to fool with her.
All right.
Harper Sear says, good year.
I just came from a house where this old lady had the biggest blanks I ever saw, to get back to the question. What did you say, Steve?
I keep trying to convert this whole unsavory scheme here to something more savory. So, old grandmother was in bed when the big bed, well, I'd say the biggest pillows.
Steve, no, it's a rotten answer there. What do you say, Brett?
I think Steve Allen is a sneak. That's what I say.
That's right.
But I tell you, I've never been so shocked, appalled, and outraged by an answer in my entire life.
I bet.
I said, bazooms.
Bazooms.
If the shoe fits, honey, put it on.
Sit down now.
She should be.
Yes. Charles, would you restore a little sanity?
I have a children's program, and I could not use a word like either of these girls you.
Yes.
Because I'm an actor from the legitimate theater, so what? I chose busts.
Oh, dear me. Yes. Speaking of bazooms, Fannie, would you show us yours?
Well, as I said earlier, the shoe.
So Fannie won't be about it. I'll show you.
Oh, it's okay. That's enough.
I'll write you next week, Mother, and tell you all that. My mother says if you have them, show them. I said berries.
She said berries.
Berries.
Steve, she said berries. Would you believe that? That's what it says there.
Yeah.
Berries.
What'd she say?
Well, I have a comment, but I think I better skip on and just go on to Richard Dawson's answer here.
Well, I do hope that the producer and the director and you will remember I was the only one who didn't walk out.
You'll do anything for your own show.
Should there be any extra close-ups over?
Yeah.
Also, I couldn't walk out because I wrote bazooms.
That's three, right? All right, what about it there,
I'll
Molly?
I'll tell you the truth. I'm embarrassed to show mine because I said feet. Because I don't think that feet sounds like it.
Feet. Okay. So at this moment, the score is 3-0. And you need 3 to stay in the game and achieve a tie. 4 matches, however, in this second and final round will win the game for you. Everyone plays.
Okay. You said it,
after,
not me.
After it was run over by a steamroller, Norman was able to slip his blank under the door. Yes. After it was run over by a steamroller, Norman was able to slip his blank under the door.
Darling.
Just want to, let's just little check in.
Oh, check
just,
away
just
your,
a check. Okay. You sure Jackie Gleason started that way? All right, everybody ready in the upper tier and the lower tier. So we call on Sue. After, oh, after it was run over by a steamroller, Norman was able to slip his blank under the door. What do you put in that blank?
Head.
Head. His head.
Wait a minute.
She said head.
Did I misunderstand the question?
No. After it was run over by a steamroller, Norman was able to slip his blank under...
Thank you.
Maybe she misunderstood the question. Oh. We'll find out right now. Head is the answer she's looking for, Steve.
Well, I hate to tell you what the question is, but be that as it may, I would say Volkswagen.
His Volkswagen.
Yeah.
All right. Slip his Volkswagen under the door. What did you say, Brett?
I didn't say Volkswagen.
No, you didn't.
And I didn't say Haid.
You didn't say Haid.
I said body.
Body. All right. No match there. What have you got, Charles?
I said Fanny.
I said hand. I'm sorry.
His hand. Now, you must match the remaining three celebrities to stay in the game. Fanny, let's see what you've got there.
I'm with Steve. I said Volkswagen.
Volkswagen. So, Valerie Wood is the winner. $100 for you. You stand by for a moment. Gotta say goodbye to pretty Sue Di Benedetto. Can you put that money to good use?
Sure can.
Well, you got Reuters there. That one especially there in the first row, your husband. We're very happy for you, Sue, that you won the money. Many thanks for being with us on Match Game 74. $5,600. There's your husband rooting for. Okay. Now, we got a little business to do with you, but first we got to do a little business with them up there, and then your turn will come, okay? See you right away.
GSN presents Behind the Blank. From 1973 to 1978, the match game was a blockbuster hit. Gene Rayburn took home blank number of daytime Emmys. Was it 5, 4, a mere 3, or none? Stay tuned for the answer.
Today's consolation prizes are the Weekender by American Tourister, designed to go everywhere by Lion Steel Air, fiberglass reinforced instructions, strong lightweight luggage by American Tourister, and a supply of Airwick solid, including rose, natural, and lemon scents. In beautiful decorated colors, Airwick works 24 hours a day to help eliminate odors. And Rice-A-Roni, the big flavor side dishes, are quick, so easy to saute and simmer to flavor perfection. Rice-A-Roni, the San Francisco treat. Match game 74 will continue in just 1 minute.
Do you know how many Emmys Gene Rayburn took home? The correct answer is D, zero. Although Gene hosted the top-rated game show for 5 consecutive years, he never won an Emmy. Yep, he got blanked. But we love you, Gene. Stay tuned for more of that 70s Hour on GSN.
Here we go.
Yes.
Ready?
Yes, I am.
Okay. Now, Valerie, you know, we polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank. Oh. Newton.
Wait.
Yeah, just keep your answers to yourself. No, listen, we appreciate your enthusiasm. I don't want to dampen that, but your answers may be misleading to her. Anyway, the answer that studio audience gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it. The second most frequent response, $250. The third, $100. Little help from celebrities. Whom would you like?
Steve.
Steve, how would you fill that blank in?
With some flowers, perhaps a little bottle of wine. Something tasteful or nicely arranged. Well, I can think of three things that I think maybe most people in the audience might have said Wayne.
Wayne Newton. Okay. All right. Another?
Charles.
Charles Nelson Reilly.
Well, having a lot of caps, stay away from a Fig Newton.
Fig Newton. Okay.
Richard.
And Richard Dawson. You, sir.
You come to me after you've used Wayne Fig, eh?
Yeah, that's right. And all the good ones are gone. What have you got?
Well, I shall say old Long John Silver himself, Robert Newton.
Robert Newton, a marvelous actor. So you've got Robert Newton, Fig Newton, and Wayne Newton. Now, you can choose one of those or give us one of your own if you'd like. What would you like to do?
Wayne.
You choose Wayne. Okay. Wrong? You think she's wrong? Well, we're going to find out right now if Wayne Newton is up there, and if so, where? First, may we see the $100 response? Sir Isaac Newton is a good answer.
Robert Newton.
Still looking for Wayne Newton. May we see the $250 response? There is Wayne Newton.
What do you think is under the 500? Fig. Fig.
Robert.
I bet you a nickel it's not Fig Newton, Ed. All right, here's a $500 response. I forgot my wallet, John. You can give everybody a nickel then. I forgot my wallet. All right, you've won the $250. That means you'll be playing for 10 times that amount, or...
Bing!
$2,500. Now, to collect, you got to match one celebrity head-to-head. Has to be exact. Choose one now, if you please.
Richard.
Richard Dawson will get ready
Robert
to write.
Robert
Newton. Oh. No, no, I can't. Valerie faces me. Here is the $2,500 question. Glass blank. G-L-A-S-S blank. All right, he's finished now. Would you fill in that blank in a way you think will match, Richard? Glass?
The only thing I could think of, menagerie.
That's funny, the only thing I could think of, too. Glass menagerie. A marvelous play. Richard, for $2,500, may we see your answer?
You son, you don't have to pay that much. Robert New. Oh. No, I couldn't. All I could think of, I swear, was glass jug.
Glass jug.
No, glassware. I'm sorry.
Yeah. So you drew a blank. That happens once in a while. It's happened to me. I'm sorry. Happened to her. Okay.
But I gave you Robert Newton.
That's right.
Three.
Okay, so you're up to $350, and we'll come back to you in a moment or so. But first, we've got to pass along this message for our audience. Just time to say goodbye. I hope you'll join us next time for Match Game 74. G. Mabry here. Bye.
This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game 74, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.